Hey everyone, thank you for being here. In this week's video, I will be attempting my first ocean resin clock. It's going to be a three-part series because otherwise it would have been a super long video and 31 minutes is already really long. So jumping right in, I purchased this clock at Walmart for $15 and I am putting XIM primer on. I think I do three coats. Yes, I did three coats and I let it dry 2 hours in between each coat. And like I said, this is a really long video, but that is only because I crammed the first 5 days into 30 minutes. So if you would like to skip ahead, that is completely fine. I just wanted to put as much as I could in this video for those that might would like to see the entire process. Okay, moving right along into day two, our primer has dried overnight, and now it is time to do the next step, which is painting the underpainting. So right here, you saw me just put down a little bit of Floetrol, and what that's going to do is help our acrylic paint move a little bit easier across our board, and it will also help the colors blend together a lot easier. So I'm just going to start at the top, painting the darkest part of the ocean, and I will transition into the white where the shoreline will be. This step will also give you a guide as to where you want to lay your ocean colors down. I really think I put too much time and effort into this, but I really enjoy doing these underpaintings. I just like to put my headphones on, listen to my music, and it's just relaxing. Okay, just sit back and watch and listen to the music, or you can feel free to skip ahead to day three. Thank you. Okay, here we are. It's day three. The underpainting has dried. I am using my Stonecoat countertops art coat. Here is the liquid latex I was telling you about, and I painted it on the bottom. It's dry, and it's going to make it a lot easier to get our resin drips up now. 91% isopropyl alcohol works really well at getting the resin off of utensils. I spray it on a rag, and then I would use the rag to wipe my gloved hands, and that would remove the resin that was on my gloves. I like to put two or three pairs of gloves on at the same time. That way it makes it really easy. If you get your hands all sticky, you can just remove your top layer of gloves and then you've got a fresh pair on underneath. It's time to mix our resin. I like to pour the hardener in first and then the resin on top. I always mix it for at least 5 minutes. Sometimes it's longer. It depends on how many ounces I'm mixing at a time. And be sure to stir it fairly slowly, but you want to scrape the sides, you want to scrape the bottom, and you want to keep mixing. If you look into your cup and you can still see strings or it's cloudy, then you need to continue mixing until it's clear. It looks like I am mixing my resin really fast, but I have it sped up. Do not mix your resin like this. You want to mix it slow. Otherwise, you will have a million micro bubbles in it, and it will be a real pain trying to get it out of your resin work. So just take your time, mix it thoroughly, and just keep mixing. And even there's been times where it's been 5 minutes, and I look at it, and I can still see that there's strings and stuff in there, and it's not mixed well. So I just keep mixing, and do not forget to scrape your sides and the bottom, because it just sticks there.
Thank you.
After your resin has been thoroughly mixed, it's time to pour some into a separate cup. We're now going to make our sand resin mixture. Just mixing that around a little bit, and I'm going to add a few scoops of sand to it. I'm also going to be adding some diamond dust, which is little small glass fragments. But what it does is it gives the sand that shimmer that you see when you're out on the beach when the sun hits it and it's reflective. So it just puts a pretty shimmer. And then I'm also going to be adding my white Alumilite. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but I'm going to put one drop into my sand resin mixture to help the sand keep its color, because once you mix the sand with resin, it makes it kind of a shade darker and it looks more like wet sand rather than dry sand. This is where I'm adding that drop. I'm going to stir that in. Okay, that might have been a little more than a drop, but I meant to just do a drop. A little goes a long way. I am also still trying to figure out the right thickness of the resin sand mixture. I guess it just depends on what kind of project you're doing. I think this time I actually made it a little too runny. I should have added more sand or less resin to it. So I'm just mixing that around, and I'm going to just place it out there on the board and start to form my shoreline. The runnier your sand mixture is, the more it's going to spread out on your board. So just keep that in mind whenever you're mixing it up. Thank you. Welcome to day four. We let our sand dry overnight, and as you can see, it looks kind of runny. I am not happy with the way that it looks at all, so I will be reapplying the sand on this layer. But we are going to start adding our shades, and here are all the colors that I'm using, and I will be listing them all in the description below as well. The first color we're going to put down is the Alumilite Translucent Ocean Blue. I did add like 2 drops of the Black Bombay India ink just to give it that darker color. The next color that I'm going to be using is the Turquoise Bombay India ink, and then my Teal Bombay India ink, followed by my Aqua Bombay India ink. I had went to Hobby Lobby one day and I had seen these colors and I thought, oh well, I'm going to try them. I think I had seen it on somebody else's YouTube channel where they have used them before, and I'm really happy with them. I really love the colors, and when you're doing the ocean, you really do want your colors to be more translucent than opaque. So you want to be able to see every layer that you put on your ocean. And what I have found is the more layers that you put on, the more dimension and depth that it gives you. And I really did end up putting a lot of layers on this clock, but it wasn't intentional. I did run into issues that I will get into on the next video. And so I had to correct them, do some sanding. I burned my resin. So I had to go back in, relay my colors, but I didn't give up, and the end result, I feel, came out beautifully. So just follow along with me and we will get through this clock together. I am putting some clear resin in a cup now. I'm getting ready to attempt waves. I am going to place some clear resin along the shoreline where I want my waves to be. Once I do that, I will drizzle the white casting craft pigment on top of the clear. I have really struggled trying to get really good waves. I have seen people put the clear resin down and they lay the white casting craft or whatever white pigment they choose to use on top, and then they blow it out into these beautiful waves that have cells and lacing, and I have really struggled with it. I've tried it the other way. I've seen people put the white pigment down first and then put the clear on top. And as I have done a few more projects, I think I've almost had better luck with putting the white pigment down first and then putting the clear pigment on top. But to each their own. I have also purchased, since this project, I purchased some pinata alcohol ink, and I have been adding that in with my white casting craft, and that has helped. That has helped some, you know, along with blowing it out. There's a certain technique to blow it out. There's different nozzles that you can use. I think you just have to find what works best for you. See, these are not the prettiest waves at all. and people say take your torch and hit your white waves with it and that will help cells come out. Well, no, did not work for me. I thought I would give it another shot. I was going to put some waves down lower on the shoreline. I was trying so hard to make my waves and my shore look good and nothing was working. And I was so upset and disappointed at this point. And I just kept trying and trying and messing with them and blowing them around and lifting it up, trying to let the waves roll down, roll out. Nothing was working. And I just could not make it look good. I was happy with the way my ocean was looking, but as far as the shoreline and my beach, no way. Okay, day five. So we're going to start with the beach. I have got to make this look better. I think the night before I was laying in bed thinking, okay, what can I do? What can I do to make this look better? What needs to happen? All kinds of things going through my head. So I am just going to start at the bottom and make this start looking like an actual beach.
Thank you.
this go around with the sand, I did make it a little bit thicker. I did add the white in with the sand again, and this here is where I'm mixing up my darker sand. I just didn't put any white pigment in it, so it's just sand and resin, and then it has that kind of naturally darker look to it, and it looks like wet sand. And that is it for day five. I'm just gonna finish my beach here. I'm gonna let it dry overnight. So please like and subscribe and join me next week for day six.